got some Southerners here, very good. Security, watch them closely, all right? So we've been doing this for over 17 years now. We've had the honor of making music for that long together, all of us up here. And, the reason that, there are different reasons for why we do what we do. I don't think there's just one. But of all the different reasons, ultimately it really comes back to this, the thing that really drives us. More than loving music and more than just even hanging out with each other, more than recording, more than doing shows, even more than having jobs doing this. What really brings us back time and time again is being reminded and knowing that there is hope for the helpless. There is rest for the weary. There is love for the broken heart. There is grace and forgiveness and mercy and healing. Relationship with God, wherever we are in life, God wants to meet you in that place. And that's a truth that I know so many people here tonight know, but it's also a truth that sometimes we forget. We need to be reminded of. So often, many people have kind of, I shouldn't say many, but there have been people who say, they look at what we do and they say, why are you doing that? Why are you playing Christian music? You should go outside of the walls of the church and you should play mainstream music that it, you know, tells people a positive message and tells people about Jesus. Go outside the walls of the church. And I agree that all of us, whatever we do, whether we drive a truck for a living or a teacher or in a band or whatever it is you do, we have to go outside the walls of the church. But at the same time, you know, those same people say, well, what you're doing, you're just preaching to the choir. And I would submit that I was in the choir for a long time and I needed to be preached to. And sometimes we have to just encourage each other, and that's kind of the calling that God has placed on us. And tonight, man, I'm not going to really talk long. I want it to be a night of celebration, but at the same time, I want to just give you an opportunity. Just give you an opportunity to really to just pray. And if you need to, come back to the Lord. Because there are many believers, I think there are many believers who kind of know the way of salvation. You know who Jesus is. You've asked him to save you. You've asked him to forgive you of your sins. You've realized in your mind and in your heart that you can't have salvation through your works. So many of us know that. And we've committed our lives to Christ. And yet there are times that are hard. There are struggles. And Jesus said that when we follow, he didn't say when we follow him that everything was going to be great and easy. He said, in fact, when you do follow me, you will have persecution. You will have people tell you, you know, put you down for your beliefs. You know, fortunately for us, for most of us, about the worst that it gets is that we get, someone tries to embarrass us or tries to keep us from, you know, saying what we want to say in a certain situation. We have many brothers and sisters, as you know, around this world who have to hide from meeting together like this. They have to hide their scriptures, the Bible. Fortunately, we live in countries that we have the freedom to be able to say what we want to say and gather as we want to. I think those freedoms are slowly dwindling down a little bit, but nothing compared to brothers and sisters that have persecution around the world. But tonight, as we come here, as Third Day comes here to encourage our brothers and sisters, the body of Christ here in the UK, we want to remind you once again that hope. And as the Apostle Paul writes throughout the New Testament, he says, don't forget your first love. Don't forget about that feeling that you had. Can you you remember what it was like when you first gave your life to Christ, when you first realized that here is a God who wants to take away your sins, to take away those burdens, to take away that guilt that we feel because of our sins? For me, it was God taking away that feeling of not knowing what I'm going to do with life, of being lost in life. So be reminded of that tonight. Cry out to Him. Tonight, there are struggling marriages here. Even Christians, struggling marriages. Tonight, there are people dealing with addictions. Believers dealing with addictions. Tonight, there are people here who are going through a physical or mental or spiritual hard time right now and need healing. Jesus wants to bring that to you. Tonight might be at a place where you just need a revelation. You just need God to reveal Himself to you tonight. So let's take that opportunity to just pray and close your eyes together and realize that. Just reach out to your right, or maybe put your hand on the shoulder of the person to your right, whether you know them or not. I want everybody to just kind of be prayed for tonight. Just know tonight when you're being prayed for. Pray for that person right now that you can lay your hand on their shoulder. Just pray for them. Pray that God will reveal Himself to them tonight.
Yeah. Thank you.